Name?
Jill Marie Connor.
Age?
I thought you weren't allowed to ask that on a job interview.
Yes, but this isn't a job interview. This is a psychological profile. What's your current living situation?
I live in an apartment with my boyfriend.
Right. Do the two of you fight often?
It's kind of personal.
You don't have to tell me if you don't want to.
I prefer not.
That's all right. The not wanting to talk about it is often more telling than the words would have been.
I've always been interested in criminal psychology. That's why my professor suggested me here.
Yes, the Liberty Memorial Psychiatric Prison. We can certainly teach you a thing or two about the mindset of a criminal. We do require that our employees have a healthy mental state. What's your relationship like with your father?
My father passed a few years ago.
How would you describe him?
He worked hard.
Well, those are all the questions I have for you. You ready to go meet your patients?
Rob McGall, assault and battery. Sent here after the court determined he was a suicide risk. Our most harmless inmate. He has a small obsession with fruit. We think he worked at a grocer. Your next client, if you will, is Darlene Aria. She has a self-imposed form of multiple personality disorder. Essentially, every time you speak with her, she'll have a new accent. Next is Rosie Fisher. She is what you could insensitively call a black widow. She seduced and killed 5 men over the course of 3 years, supposedly for cheating on her. Very needy, desperate for attention. Never entirely grew out of the terrible twos. Your fourth and final patient is Sue Milligan. She's a serial killer. You'll be monitored at all times while speaking with her. She's tied down and incapable of much movement, but better safe than sorry.
Doesn't hurt anymore.
What did you do to make it stop hurting?
You're scared of people knowing.
You're scared that no one is ever going to know. You're scared that you've exaggerated what
you didn't really like to save yourself. You're scared that it's never going to go away.
Stop!
You're scared it's never going to go away.